ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं धीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवते उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवती नैष्ठिके। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद्भागवतम 10th कांटो चैप्टर 4 द एट्रोसिटीज ऑफ किंग कंस टेक्स्ट 21। तस्मात् भद्रे शोतनया मया व्यपादितान् अपि मानुषोच यतः सर्व सोकृतां विन्दते अवसः। तस्माद् भद्रे स्वतनया मया व्यापादितान् अपि मानुषोच यतः सर्व सकृतान् विन्दते अवसः। वर्ड मीनिंग तस्मात् देयरफोर भद्रे माय डियर सिस्टर ऑल ऑस्पिशियस नेशन टू यू स्वतनयान् फॉर योर ओन सन्स मया बाय मी व्यापादितान् अनफॉर्चुनेटली किल्ड अपि अल्दो मानुषोच डू नॉट बी अग्रीव्ड यतः बिकॉज सर्वः एवरीवन सो कृतम द फ्रुटिव रिजल्ट्स ऑफ वन्स ओन डीड्स विन्दते सफर्स अरेंजेस अवसह अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ प्रोविडेंस। ट्रांसलेशन एंड पार्पोर्ट बाय डिवाइन ग्रेस अभय चरणा अरविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी शिल प्रभुपाद। शिल प्रभुपाद की जय। ट्रांसलेशन माई डियर सिस्टर देवकी ऑल गुड फॉर्च्यून ऑन टू यू एवरी वन सफर्स एंड एंजॉयस द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ हिज ओन वर्क under the control of providence. Therefore, although your sons have unfortunately been killed by me, please do not lament for them. Please repeat, my dear sister Devaki, all good fortune unto you. Everyone suffers and enjoys the results of his own work. Under the control of providence. Therefore, although your sons have unfortunately been killed by me, please do not lament for them. Purport. स्टेटेड इन ब्रह्म संहिता 554 यस्तिन्द्र गोपम अथवेन्द्र होस कर्म बंधानुरूप फलभाजनवातनोति कर्माणि निर्दहति किन्तु च भक्तिभाजाम् गोविंदमादि पुरुषम तमहं भजामि। एवरीवन बिगिनिंग फ्रॉम द स्मॉल इंसेक्ट नोन एज इंद्र गोप अप टू द इंद्र द किंग ऑफ द हेवनली प्लैनेट्स इज ऑब्लाइज्ड टू अंडरगो द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ हिज फ्रुटिव एक्टिविटीज। वी मे सुपरफिशियली सी दैट वन इज सफरिंग और एंजॉइंग बिकॉज ऑफ सम एक्सटर्नल कजेस बट द रियल कॉज इज वन्स ओन फ्रुटिव एक्टिविटीज। इवन व्हेन समवन किल्स समवन एल्स इट इज टू बी अंडरस्टूड दैट द पर्सन हु वॉज किल्ड मेट द फ्रुटिव रिजल्ट्स ऑफ हिज ओन वर्क and that the man who killed him acted as the agent of material nature. Thus Kamsa begged Devaki's pardon by analyzing the matter deeply. He was not the cause of death of Devaki's sons. Rather, this was their own destiny. Under the circumstances, Devaki should excuse Kamsa and forget his past deeds without lamentation. Kamsa admitted his own fault, but whatever he had done was under the control of Providence. Kamsa might have been the immediate cause for the death of Devaki's sons, but the remote cause was their past deeds. This was an actual fact. Om Ajnanati Mirandhasya Jnananjana Shailakaya चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरुभे नमः। श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं जनभूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। वन्दे अहं श्रीगुरुः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथानितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्ण चैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपदान् सहगण ललिता श्रीविशाखानितांश्च। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामीनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषः शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। नमो महावदान्याय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नामिने गौरतिशे नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकांत राधाकांत नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विशभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। सो वी आर हियरिंग द प्रीचिंग ऑफ कम्स टू हिज ओन सिस्टर देवकी एंड हिज ब्रदर इन लॉ वसुदेव। एज एवरी डे वी आर हियरिंग दिस बैकग्राउंड दैट दिस देवकी एंड कम्स they have the relationship as brother and sister. Devaki's sister, Kamsa was the elder brother. Devaki was daughter of Devaka, and Kamsa was son of Ugrasen. Ugrasen and Devaka, they are brothers. So in this way, in one family, it is like a joint family. So they have relation, nice relation, Kamsa and Devaki. They have sweet relation as brother and sister. And that's why it was marriage ceremony of Devaki and Vasudeva, and in their marriage procession, Kamsa was driving the chariot himself. Of course, it is in a Hindu tradition that when the sister married, sister was going to his father-in-law's house or his husband's, her husband's house, then brother should accompany the sister. But the sweet relationship between Kamsa and Devaki was suddenly changed because of this. Forecasted their Kamsa's future from this. These words he heard from the sky. That O Kamsa, you are driving the chariot, but you did not know that the eighth child of this Devaki will be the cause of your death or kill you. So after hearing these words, how Kamsa immediately changed, he just cut in one hand, he cut the hairs of Devaki, and in another hand he took his sword, just about to chop off the head of Devaki from her body. But immediately Vasudeva, by his divine intelligence, by somehow or other, he saved Devaki. So then we have heard that was the situation of why Kamsa imprisoned Vasudeva and Devaki. But when the Kamsa killed first six children of Devaki, and seventh was Sankarsana, came to Gokul, born from mother Rohini's womb. And then eighth child was transferred from Mathura to Gokul as Krishna. And this was the real daughter of Jasoda, just Vasudev brought him from Gokul. And so they gave to Devaki, and the child was in Devaki's lap. But as Kamsa heard from the doorkeepers or the guards that the eighth child was born, so he came immediately to this spot. His hair was cut, and he was completely mad. So Devaki tried her best, praying her own brother very sincerely in a piteous condition, but all her effort was useless. Kamsa did not listen to anything, just caught the legs of that small baby child, daughter of Jasoda, and just like he killed other six children. So now he was trying to kill that child also. But surprisingly, the child was slipped upwards from the hand of Kamsa. Kamsa was surprised, how someone could slip from my hand, a baby child. So he was just looking up, surprisingly. Then immediately he saw 800 Durga Devi in the sky. And Durga Devi was shouting, "O Kamsa, you fool! What will be the use of killing me? The Supreme Personality of Godhead, who has been your enemy from the very beginning and who will certainly kill you, has already taken his birth somewhere else. Therefore, do not unnecessarily kill other children. So after hearing, because Kamsa was a devotee of Durga, so after hearing these words, he was completely surprised. He has to believe the words of Durga, because so before he heard Jai Sri Gauranitya Krishna Balaram Sri Radha Shyam Sundar, before he heard whatever he heard from the demigods as a woman from the heavenly, from heaven, or whatever he heard from Narada Muni, he forgot everything. He told all these statements definitely false, because whatever my worshipable deity, the Durga, has spoken, that is true. That's why he was completely now changed. His heart was melted and repenting from his previous karma. But sometimes he also asking Devaki and Vasudev to excuse him. Whatever he did, that is because of, it was unfortunately been killed by me. Please do not lament for them, because they are suffering for their own previous karma. Everyone is suffering for their previous karma. So we may superficially see that one is suffering and enjoying because of some external causes, but the real cause is one's own fruitive activities. So Prabhupada wrote that Kamsa might have been the immediate cause for the death of Devaki's sons, but the remote cause was their past deeds. This was an actual fact, because the six sons of Devaki, and they have also their previous life, in previous, originally they are the sons of Marichi. Then they have a sweet relation with Brahma, but in one incident when Brahma was running after his own daughter Bak, so being attracted by the beauty of that his own daughter, so these six sons of Marichi, they started laughing at Brahma. This old man running after his own daughter, when they are laughing, because Brahma of course come to his senses, but he cursed them. You have to go to the in a demoniac species. So they fell down from heavenly planet and born as the son of Kalanemi in Hiranyakashipu's family. So Kamsa in his previous life was Kalanemi. And these six sons of Marichi, they are the son of Kalanemi. Previous birth, actually they are all sons of Kamsa. And in this lifetime, Kamsa was practically killing his own sons in previous life. So actually this is that's why Prabhupada told this was an actual fact. So everyone is suffering or enjoying because of their past deeds, their own karma. So that is Kamsa try to express his thought to Devaki and Vasudev. But as yesterday class, there is a nice point that the features like Hiranyakashipu and Kamsa, they're telling the Shastra, no doubt. This was from their the knower of the Vedic conclusions or Shastra. But fact that they did not want to follow it in their own life. They have preached this to others. They ask others to follow the principles, but this is not for them. So that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, Apani Achari Prabhu Jibera Sikhai. Apani Achari Dharma Karimu Prachar. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that. One must follow the principles himself in his own life, then he tried to preach others. Eita Siddhanta Vede Bhagavate Kaya. This is the conclusion of in Veda and Bhagavata. So this is also the difference between a devotee preacher and a professional and just outside preacher. The preaching is the essence, no doubt, but Hiranyakashipu and Kamsa, they are also preaching. So what is the difference between the preachings of Prahlad? Prahlad Maharaj was also preaching, and Hiranyakashipu also preaching. But a devotee's preaching, devotee is Prahlad like he is a Mahajan, because he is acting himself and he also preaching. He got this knowledge from Parampara, from Narada Muni, and he is preaching it. So Mahajana Janagatasya Pantha. So we have to follow the footprints of the Mahajans. Those who are teaching us with their own example. That's why so many preachers, we see Bhagavatam, there are so many reciters of Bhagavatam, professional reciters. But everyone was trying to preach Bhagavatam all over the world, but no one was successful. It was only even Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur sent his own disciples. One of his disciples even told from London that Guru Maharaj, you have to give permission for drinking tea and smoking and all these things. And same time they may be, and you also allow this dress. All this change the dress and Bhakti Saraswati Thakur became very angry. He told, I don't want to see your face, come back. But we see how Prabhupada's preaching was effective because of he was following strictly the instruction of his spiritual master, and is preaching these four regulative principles. He's telling to follow these four regulative principles and he preach as it is, his spiritual master gave the knowledge. That's why Prabhupada told, preaching is the essence, but purity is the force. Many professional reciters, they know very nicely. Very Sanskrit verses, the verse, everything. They preach so nicely. But there is no effect on the listeners. Just like Sanatana Goswami told, Avaishnamba Mukhad Girna Puta Hari Katha Amritam Sravanam Naiva Kartavyam Sarpa Uchishta Jathapaya. Even milk is like nectar, it is nectarian. But if a snake just drink little milk and he left, then the whole milk become poisonous. Similarly, the Bhagavatam or Gita, they are no doubt the words of the Supreme Lord or the Vedic conclusions, they are nectarian, but because it is just tossed a wicked person who is never and who has no intention to follow the instructions but want to use it for their own purpose, sense gratification. They want to use it for own end. Kamsa is also like one such preacher. The professor Maya, so Mayavadi Bhashya Sunile Hoy, Sarvanas. So he knows the Shastra, but he wants only when it needs for himself, and use it. Otherwise, he himself in the practical life did not want to follow it. So that's why the preaching did not act. Devaki and Vasudev, they know comes, but in the particular situation, they believe. They know that they have already changed this their son with they also keep everything hiding because of this is Lord's instruction. So now this is the difference between a professional preacher and a real preacher. And so that's why everyone is suffering or enjoying because of their previous karma. But still in this verse, Prabhupada quoting that the karmani nirdahati kintucha bhakti bhajam. Kintucha bhakti bhajam. This law of karma did not act for the devotees. Kintucha, the devotees are not subject to this law of karma. They were directly controlled by the Supreme Lord Himself. They completely depend upon the Supreme Lord. Pandavas are suffering, or Devaki, Vasudeva are suffering. This is not for their previous karma. They are simply depending on the Supreme will of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And they firm faith that whatever is happening, that is happening in the will of the Supreme Lord, and this is for our benefit. Tattenukampa susamikhyamana punjana eva krita vipakam. We may have to suffer lot of suffering because of our karmic reaction, but because of the Supreme Lord, He gave up us a little punishment or little suffering. This is the the devotee, they thinks like this. But Kamsa, he is telling, you are suffering your karma, your own karma. Don't he want to escape himself? He don't want to take responsibility for himself. He is telling, simply excuse me. It happened. I am just act as a instrument in hand of material nature. Of course, it is mentioned in Gita, prakrute kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasah ahankara vimudhatma karta ahangiti manyate. Actually, everything happened by the material natures. But there is also the supreme will of Supreme Personality of Godhead. Because in Bhagavad Gita, in the 18th chapter, in the 14th verse is mentioned, there's five reasons. Whatever is happening, there is a there is this body and the owner of the body, the soul, and different senses, and then the activities of different senses, they are trying to achieve something, but the final cause is daiva evatra panchamam. The concluding reason is daiva. This is Kamsa is preaching in this way, just to thinking this is only in this case is applicable, but he himself did not want to apply it in his own life. Because if he has heard this voice that the eighth child of Devaki kill you, then why? So this is, he did not think that this is because of my own previous karma, but rather he thinking this Devaki is cause of my death, or her eighth child will be death, my cause of my death. And he was trying to kill immediately to Devaki, but now he is same person, he is preaching Devaki. Just blame me, it is happened because of your their previous karma, this your this six children were killed by me. So, this is the principle. But a devotee, he always depend upon Krishna. And even a person is under the shelter of a Vaishnava. If a Vaishnava also can change the life of others, if he will, if someone depend upon him. Just like we see how Prabhupada went to Western world for preaching. So when they after they read Nectar of Devotion, they had written that unless someone performs some devotional service in his previous life, in this life he cannot start devotional service. So come to Prabhupada, told that Prabhupada, then we have been in your previous life, definitely we have performed some devotional service. Otherwise how we become devotee in this life is written in Nectar of Devotion. But Prabhupada immediately rejected their arguments. They told, no, it is because by my causeless mercy only. Only by the causeless mercy of a Vaishnava, then one can become a devotee. A Vaishnava can buy cars or buy blessing, can change the life of other living entities. Narada Muni changed this. Nalakubera and Manigriva. By simply cursing, they send them to Gokul. They're just as Jamal Arjun tree. The trees of this Jamal Arjun. Finally, they achieve the supreme abode, the lotus feet of Krishna. So, if a Vaishnava, a devotee can also change our destiny. If we depend upon a Vaishnava and take shelter of a Vaishnava, like Srila Prabhupada, it's going to be because of we are under his shelter. So, Prabhupada can change. Change others. Like we may have so many prarabdhas and wars. But if we believe that, if you take full shelter, Saranga Saranagati Hoibe Jahara Tahara Prathana Sune Sinanda Kumar. If you completely surrender to Krishna or completely surrender to his pure representative, pure devotee, and by their blessings, this Karma Madhana. Karmani nirdahati kintucha bhakti bhajam. Those who are performing devotional service under the full shelter and complete shelter of a Vaishnava Acharya or by Supreme Lord, he can just overcome the reactions of these karmic reactions. It is not applicable to everyone. But others, those who are not doing devotional, not accepting devotional service, they are subject to this karmic law. Because whatever activities you are doing, Krishna told in Bhagavad Gita, there is karma, akarma, and vikarma. This karma, that is, according to Vedic injection, we are doing certain activities that is also sanctioned by Veda. Vedic rules. But our purpose is sense gratification. That is karma. That is karma. Our purpose is sense gratification. And for that, we are taking shelter of Veda and all Vedic injections and following this strictly. So this is karma because it is sanctioned in Vedic literatures. But Bikarma, those who are simply, the demoniac people, they simply want to gratify their senses but without following Vedic injections. By their own, the whimsically they act, they acting whimsically and want to satisfy their senses. It's Bikarma. So this karma is also known as Punya Karma, pious activities, and Bikarma is impious, sinful activities. For sinful, by doing performing sinful activities, one has to go to hell or hellish planets. and performing the pious activities, go to heaven. But a devotee is not has nothing to do with heaven or hell. That is another karma that devotees act, a karma. Or means they did not get the reaction of their activities because they surrendered everything to Krishna. That every activity is according to the supreme will of Krishna. According to Krishna's will, they depend upon him. Nija bala chesta prati bharasa chadiya tumara ichhare achi nirbhara kariya. Because they know that everything is happening by the supreme will of the supreme personality of Godhead. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote that tava ichha mate jibera janama marana samruddhi nipata dukha sukha sanghatana. He told, oh Lord, everything happened. A living entities. Jivera janama marana, whether birth and death of a living entity is happening because of your supreme will. Jivan marana samruddhi nipata. Samruddhi is his development or his whatever he is doing in his life, or his if you like, you can destroy him. Samruddhin patar, whether he is falling to the hellish planets, and whatever the happiness and distress we are experiencing in our life, everything is due to your supreme will. So in this way, a devotee completely depend upon Krishna. So if someone is completely depending on Krishna, then he is not subject to this karmic reactions. One can even conquer death if he is a tax shelter and Vaishnava or Supreme Lord. You can see many examples in Puranas. About Markandeya Rishi. It was destined that, it is destined that he will live for 7 years. This boon was given by Brahma. What is lifespan? 7 years. That's why Markandeya Rishi and his wife, the parents of Markandeya, they are crying. Where he reached 7 years. She told, why you are crying? They are taking, always embracing the child and crying. Then he told, because this is our final year that we are getting your reception, then you, end of this year, you have to die. This is according to your previous karma. It is destined by the by Brahma himself. So he told, don't, we can change it. He left immediately home, and the Saptarishi is there. They advised him to do Vishnu Bhakti, but in his village, in the nearly and forest, they had found a Sankha Shiva temple. Then he was Shiva Lord Shiva, he also Vaishnu Manang Jata Sambhu. And he in shelter, he was doing his bhajan. Even the Jamadutas, they go away seeing that he's in Shiva Mandir and doing a chanting Lord's name. So finally Jamaraj himself came. Take him, because he has to follow the cycle of karma is there. He has to go. He has to die. Whether he would go to higher planet or lower planet, but he has to die. But he changed. Immediately Lord Shiva come out, because he's seeing this Jamaraj, he was embracing the Shiva Linga. Lord Shiva came out. I told him, you are dare to, you did not fear, because of, you don't know he's in my shelter, he's chanting my Lord's name. Who are you? Lord Shiva became so angry, he took it redundant. He practically killed Jamaraj in the spot. So everyone was just, doing what to do, all the demigods, everyone there, and And so, even this, all demigods, they pray to Vishnu, then Lord Vishnu appeared in the spot. What to do? Jamaraj will be killed, then how can he? Who will do this judgment of pious activities or impious activities, the sinful activity? Who will give the decision? Lord Vishnu told, okay, don't worry. He asked, Lord, who gave boon for 7 years? Because everyone wants to keep their word. Brahma wants, my word must be followed. I told him 7 years is parama, is a lifespan. So, and Jamaraj, the demigods wants Jamaraj also to be lying. Lord Shiva also has to be pacified. Shiva. So Lord Vishnu came. Krishna told, okay, who gave him 7 years boon? It is Brahma gave boon. So it will be the 7 years in the years of Brahma. Because Brahma told 7 years. And what is the 7 years Brahma? In one day of Brahma, there is 1,000 yuga cycles in 12 years, in 12 hours in Brahma. 1,000 yuga cycles, Satya Tratya Dwapar is passing away. So, if someone takes shelter of the Supreme Lord or his representative, a pure devotee, then he can cross everything. Lord can change everything. So for the demoniac peoples, like Kamsar, for them they have to follow this this karma cycle of Bharatan. But kintucha bhakti bhajam. Karmani nirdahati kintucha bhakti bhajam. From the insect, this Indra Gopa, and up to the heavenly, the king of heaven, Indra, they all are follow this karma, this law of karma, but except a pure devotee. Or a person who takes shelter of a pure devotee, or Krishna, then Krishna can save them, save their life. So that's why those were, one time Navajagandhra Maharaj was giving class, he told, he saw some astrologer, and then the astrologer told, you are a fortunate soul, you are so fortunate. You are calculating his jataka, anyhow. So he came to Prabhupada, he told Prabhupada, this astrologer told, I am a very fortunate person. So Prabhupada told, that's why you come to me. Otherwise, how you came to me? By his Brahmanda Brahmite Kon? Bhagyavan ji, it is only a fortunate soul, not everyone. Kon Bhagyavan ji, Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Bij. So by getting the shelter of a Vaishnava is not an ordinary thing. If someone gets shelter of a Vaishnava, then he is fortunate soul. Bhagyavan ji. So those who are in ISKCON and taking shelter in lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada, they are not ordinary living entities. So that's why we must strictly follow Srila Prabhupada. That is, Prabhupada told, preaching is the essence, but purity is the force. Whatever we are speaking, whatever, we must act ourselves. Free from name, fame and distinctions. Puja man, pratishtha, Vaishnava, this told, it is like a hog's tool for a Vaishnava. Vaishnava just act for pleasure of Guru and Krishna. Okay, it is already time. I stop here. Any question or comment? Yes. Mike,
Krishna, thank you for your request. If during the decision that we take for preach, we found some other good influence, should we accept or can it change our destiny? If we said we will do like this and something else arrived, should we keep the line or ask?
So, okay, I could not follow, what is she asking?
My question is, if we have a mission and you are outside, for example, in distribution, you have a mission and time, and something happened for change the program, should we include that or think it would change my destiny and project?
We are going into book distribution. We cannot go for book distribution. So this is because of our own laziness. We cannot for our own. After everything, we cannot just blame for Krishna. At least, book distribution is a devotional activity. So we are dear. If it is the order of our spiritual master, then we have to follow strictly. Only limitation is when a spiritual master gives some other service, then it's okay. Or authority gave some other, but you must engage in devotional service. And we can do all nonsense and tell it is according to my my destiny. Then Kamsa is also telling. He killed this all children. Then he is thinking this is because of you should not lament and advising Devaki. Don't lament. This is just. Before it is destined to be happen like this. Even if it is true, but still our mentality should not be like this. Okay.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thanks for the nice sermon. The way you said karma, the thing into Vivada, we see many times that we are suffering. So should we conclude that because we are not
ready devotees, you know, we're
just practicing this, we are still suffering.
We are suffering.
Yeah,
yes. Only we are not completely surrendered. According to our jo jathamang prapadyante tam tathaiva bhajami. According to a proportion of our surrender, we are getting the result. If someone is completely surrendered, their thing is different. So there's Krishna always protect them. Everything happened because they have no other shelter. Completely depend upon Krishna. Like Srila Prabhupada or Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they completely depend upon Krishna. Whatever happening, then that is Krishna's will. But for us, we are not complete. Those who are fully not surrendered, 100% not surrendered, they are according to their proportion of surrendering. They get the result.
Thank you, ma'am.
I'd like to elaborate a little more on your question. First, we understand that our destination is Vaikuntha. So Vaikuntha means we have the consciousness fixed on the lotus feet of Krishna, then that suffering is irrelevant. So Queen Kunti, what did she say when she was speaking? She says, continue to put me into tribulations, because therefore I will be more focused on you. So when you become in anxiety, living in the material world, and you let this overpower your desire to serve, and then you have to be an